Hello everyone, welcome to Network Automation Tutorial. And in this video, we'll see how to add devices into YANG Suite and how to add YANG file repositories directly from devices or GitHub and how to test RESTCONF API methods like put, post, patch and delete from YANG Suite. So I'll be using CSR1000V for testing APIs. You can even test the same things using Nexus. And first we will add the device. So I need to click on create new device. I'll give CSR1000V and 0.63. And I'll give the IP 192.168.0.63. Username, password. And I'm not using TLS authentication, so I can leave that empty. And I'm not using gNMI, so I'll enable netconf. So SSH key validation I'm disabling because I'm not using SSH key, valid SSH key. So, and we can test all these protocols, RESTCONF, SSH and netconf. I'll click on create profile. After creating it, we can test the connectivity. So here connection is successful. We can see it supports ping, netconf, RESTCONF and SSH. I have enabled netconf and RESTCONF in this particular device. Now first we will try how to add YANG repository directly from the device. So I'll create a new repository and I will call CSR1000V repo. I'll call, and here I'll click on netconf. I can give the device which we added earlier, and I'll click on get schema list. So now if we go to the terminal of our YANG Suite server, so you can see it is downloading the file directly from the device, all the YANG files, and click on download selected schemas. Now here we should be able to see the download progress. After this, we'll see how to download it from GitHub. It will take a couple of minutes to download this file, so I'll pause the video. So now download is successful. Now we can go and check here. In the YANG module repository, you can see CSR1000V, and this has downloaded 543 modules from the router. Now if I go to the repositories, and I'll be able to see this particular repository which we downloaded. Same way, if you need to download it from GitHub, so we'll try to download a Nexus data model from GitHub. So I will call that nx-os. GitHub. We'll download 9.3.10 versions data model because that is a device which is running in our lab. And this time I'll select Git, and I can take this URL. I'll put it here, and branch name is main, and directory name we need to go to vendor Cisco NX, and we'll take 9.3.10. I'll copy this. Paste it here. I'll click on import YANG files. This also will take a couple of minutes. So I will pause the video here. We should be able to see the progress, the download progress. This is going to GitHub and downloading. So here download is successful now. So here this has downloaded 143 modules from GitHub. Now if you go to our YANG files and repositories, we'll have two repositories. One is for 1000V and another is for Nexus OS. And next step is you need to create a YANG module set. It is like a filter for our repository file. So I'll click on create new YANG set and I will call that iOSXR native set, and file repository I'll select CSR1000V and click on create, and from here I'll filter native, click on that, and add. I'll click on add selected. So you can see here now this itself is identifying there are some dependencies for this particular model, so all these has to be imported. I can just click on locate and add missing dependencies. So everything will get added here, and my set name is iOSXR native set. And now I have a repository and I have a set. Now if you want to go and explore this data model, you can go to YANG model and click on this particular set and select native, load modules, and this will load all the modules which is part of native. And here we will be doing changes on IP, route. We will try to update the routes. We'll try adding some static routes, deleting and all using protocol RESTCONF. So for that we'll go to protocol RESTCONF, select the YANG set as native set, and device I'll select CSR1000V, YANG module I'll select native, and depth limit I can give no limit, load modules. Now this will load this native module. Now I'll be making changes to the routing table. So before making changes, we'll look into the current routing table. Show run pipe include IP route. Currently I have multiple static routes. Okay, we need to click it again. I think accidentally the page has reloaded. Now I'll select the native. Click on load module. We'll go to IP, then route. After that, we need to click on generate APIs. So APIs are generated. You can click on show APIs. So these are the APIs related to IP route. So first, to get the route details, we can go to get. Let me minimize the patch. I'll go to get. Click on try it out. Execute. So here we should be able to see the current routing table, the static routes. So default route is 0.1. And then we have 1.1, 2 gigabit 1, 1.2, 3 and 4. And here we should be able to see the same route. Now, if we want to add additional routes to it, we need to do patch. If you do put here, this will erase all the current routes and add only the route what we are going to add. So if you want to append values, then you need to do patch. So first we'll try patch, then we will do a put method. I'll click on patch, try it out. And I'll delete this data. And I already have some data, kept it here. This will add additional route 1.10 with gigabit 1. Now we don't have 1.10 here. I'll copy this, put it in patch. I'll execute. And you can take this API details and put it into Python script as well. So we have received 204 success. Now we can verify the route. So now we have 1.10 added in our routing table. Now if we try with the same data, if you try the post method, we'll see what will happen. First we'll check the put method, then we'll look into post. In the post method, I'll click on try it out. Previously I had all these routes. Now after execution, we'll see what will happen. So here also we have received 204. Now if you see, we have only this route available. I'll manually copy and paste other routes. Put will erase all the previous config and this will push only the current config. And patch will append the values. Now with same data, we will try the post. I'll minimize patch, put, and we will try post. Click on try editing. I'll click on execute. Here we'll be getting an error. Bad request. because in post we can only create the object. If object is already present, post will not accept the data. So what we can do is we will see what is delete method. So before delete, we can verify the route. So these routes we have added earlier. Click on try it out and execute. Now let us verify the routing table. So now entire route is gone. Now we can do the post method. So I have the post data also available in the notepad, so I'll copy this. So while creating new object only, we can use the post method. I'll paste it. And now we'll try executing. So now we have received 201 and we'll verify the routing table. Now using post we have added the configuration. So here patch will be appending the configuration to the existing routing table. Post will remove all the existing and add whatever we are adding here. Put will remove the existing configuration and that will add whatever we are adding here. Then post will be creating new object if object is not present, else this will throw the error. Delete will delete the entire configuration, and get also we have seen get will show the configuration, and all these same APIs you can copy and paste it into Python script and execute, you will be getting same outputs. I hope this video was helpful for you to understand all these RESTCONF API methods like patch, put, post and delete. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.